In this session, we are going to solve the convergent divergent nozzle problems by using Mollier diagram at a maximum discharge condition. For this, there is an example. This is the example. A dry saturated steam at a pressure of 8 bar enters into a convergent divergent nozzle and leaves at a 1 bar. If the flow is asymptotic and the corresponding index of expansion is 1.135, find the ratio of cross-sectional area at exit to the throat for the condition of maximum discharge. So here, for the maximum discharge conditions, here dry steam has entered the convergent divergent nozzle at 8 bar pressure and it leaves the divergent section at 1 bar, and index of expansion, that is n, is equal to 1.135, and the expansion follows the asymptotic process. So the data given is that dry saturated steam at P1 is equal to 8 bar as it enters into the convergent divergent nozzle and leaves the nozzle at 1 bar, that is P3, as this problem belongs to the convergent divergent nozzle. So entry pressure is P1 and exit pressure from the divergent section is P3. For the maximum discharge conditions, the formula for the maximum discharge conditions, that is P2 by P1 is equal to 2 by n plus 1 whole to the power of n by n minus 1. Here n is mentioned as a 1.135. you can take n is equal to 1.135 by calculating 2 by n plus 1 whole to the power of n by n minus 1 is equal to 0.579. as already p is already given as a 8 bar, you can simply calculate the p2, that is p1 into 0.78, that is p2, 8 into 0.578 is equal to 4.6 bar. That is, P2 is the pressure at the throat. Okay. Actually, what they asked to find, that is the, find the ratio of cross-sectional areas at exit and throat. That is, so they are asking to find the ratio of A3 by A2. A3 by A2. There is a formula for the maximum discharge, that is A1 V1 by specific volume, that is A3 V3. This is the exit area discharge and this is the throat area discharge. That is, this is the equation of continuity, that is A3 V3 by X3 VS3 is equal to A2 V2 by X2 VS2. By using this formula, you can calculate the ratios for A3 by A2. This is the A3 and this is the A2. So by modifying this formula as A3 by A2, that is, this value is going to here, that is A3 by A2, that is V2 X3 VS3 by V3 X2 VS2. So here the unknowns are V2, V3, X3, X2, VS3, VS2. So from this, you can calculate the V2. V2 is the velocity at the throat. V3 is the velocity at the exit. X3 is the dryness fraction at the exit. X2 is the dryness fraction at throat. These are the specific volumes at exit and throat. Yes, the formula for V2, that is the velocity, that is 44.72 square root of H1 minus H2. For V3, the same formula, 44.72 and H1 minus H3. So here you can, the X3 and X2 can be read from the Mollier diagram. Both VS3 and VS2 can find these values from the steam tables. So these are the, this is the formula. So these are the, this is A3 by A2. This is the, you can, as you rearrange this equation into this one. So these are the unknowns, V2, V3. These are the formulas, X3 and X2 from Mollier diagram, VS3 and VS2 from steam tables. very simple. As the Mollier diagram, Mollier diagram here, I want to draw the Mollier diagram. In this Mollier diagram, this is the enthalpy in y direction. This is the entropy. This is the saturated line. This is the superheated region. This is the wet region. In this section, so in Mollier diagram, there are pressure lines. So first of all, you identify the pressure line, that is, as the pressure at inlet is 8 bar line. So this is the saturated line. So you tick this point, that as 8 bar line and a saturated line. Saturated means that is x is equal to 1. As the steam enters in the nozzle at 8 bar pressure at the condition of dry saturated, that is x is equal to, this is the point 1. And exit pressure is, you identify another line of 1 bar, that is 1 bar. So here, as the flow inside the nozzle is asymptotic, draw a straight line by using the scale, straight line. From this you can draw a straight line. So that is from 8 bar to condition 1 to condition 3. You can read the values here directly from here, that is H1, this is H2. As you already calculate the P2 value, as P2 value is equal to 4.6, you can identify the another pressure line, that is P2. So first of all, you draw a straight line from P1 to P3 directly. After that, you identify the, you select the line, that is P is equal to 4.6 bar line. Then you tick the point 2. Then you can read the value at H2. So now you can check in Mollier diagram. Here this is the actual Mollier diagram. These are the pressure lines. This is the saturated line. This is the x is equal to 1 line, that is the saturation line. This is x is equal to 9 line, that is the as I already told, that this is the wet region, this is the superheated region. So as the steam enters at this condition, that is, this is the pressure lines. This is the pressure line, this is equal to P is equal to 1, that is in megapascal, that is 1 megapascal is equal to 10 bar. So 1 mega, this is the 10 bar line. The line below this is 10 bar line, this is 9 bar line, this is 8 bar line. So I ticked a mark, this is for 1. And after that, I draw a straight line from this point to, this is the 1 bar line. I draw a straight line. So from this, I can directly taken as a value, this is the H1. This is the H1, this is the H3. After that, there is another, that is P2. So P2, this is the line, that is a 5 bar line. So as the 4.6 here, this is the 4 bar line, this is the 5 bar line. So in between that 4.2, I take this as a, and I directly read the H2 as this. So I already measured the values. This is the H1. H2, H3, as H1 is measured as 22, as here you can observe that this is 2700, 2800, this is the straight line, so this is the 2500, 2700, here also you can this is 2410 H3, and H2 is equal 2660. So you can also read X2 and X3 from Mollier diagram itself. That is, here this is the point 3. You can recognize this line. These are the dryness fraction lines. This is the line which touches the point, that is, this is the, as this is x is equal to 0.9. So two lines behind this, that is x is equal to 9, x is equal to 8, 9, 8, 8. That is x3 is equal to 0.88, and x2, this is the point, this is the x is 9.5, this is x is equal x2 is equal to 0.96. I have already noted these points. So here all the values h1 h2 h3 x2 x3, all these values can be directly read from the, you can directly read from the Mollier diagram, simple steps. So after that, but here remaining values, that is vs3 and vx2, these can be drawn from steam tables. So at p2, that is vs2 can be read at 4.6 bars, at 4.6 bars at steam tables. Steam tables for 4.6 bar, 4.6 bar steam tables. This is the VC, that is, this is the value VS, 0.40, 501, 506, and for 2 bar, 0.88, 540. So point, this is 1 bar, not 2 bar, this is one for 1 bar, 1.6937. So all the values are taken. So you can simply submitting the values in the ratio, that is A3 by A2, as we are already, formula is already written here, that is V2, X3, VS3, V3, X2, VS2, as you know that the formulas for V2 and V3, that is 44.72 square root of H1 minus H2, 44.72 square root of H1 minus H3, L H1 and H2 are already read from this Mollier diagram. At the same time, H1 and H3 are also read, and you, after submitting the values here, you, this is the answer, that is the V2 is equal to 469 meters per second, V3 is equal to 848 meters per second. So all the values, V2 is known, V3 is calculated, X3 is from Mollier diagram, X2 is from Mollier diagram, VS3 from steam tables, VS2 from steam table at 4.6 bar. So by submitting all the values, you can achieve the ratio of cross sectional area A3 by A2. Here one more example in the same line, that is the flow of steam through the convergent divergent nozzle at maximum discharge condition. And another important point in this problem is there is a 10% loss in divergent section. That is one of the important point you should assume, that is you should note, that is 10% lost in only divergent section part only. So this is the problem. A wet steam passes through a convergent divergent nozzle with a pressure of 9 bar and dryness fraction 0.9 to a pressure of 2 bar. Find the maximum discharge condition. For the maximum discharge condition, the ratio of cross sectional area at the throat and outlet, that is throat and outlet, that is A2 by A3. Here A2 by A3, the ratio of A2 by A3 is asking for the calculations. So in this divergent part of the nozzle, the total heat drop is assumed 10% is lost. So in the previous problem, there are steam enters at a dry saturate condition, but here steam is entered as a wet steam. That is, the steam enters the convergent divergent nozzle at a pressure of 9 bar, that is P1 is equal to 9 bar, and as it is a wet steam, it should be mentioned with its dryness fraction, that is 0.9, and the exit pressure 2 bar, that is P3 is equal to 2 bar. So here, that is P1, that is 9 bar, P2, 2 bar. And dryness fraction is also 0.9 at maximum discharge condition. And at the same time, this is, as it is a convergent divergent nozzle, so you should calculate the pressure at the throat section. As the formula, you know that is P2 by P1 is equal to 2 by n plus 1 to the power of n by n minus 1. So in the previous problem, n is given as some value, but here n is not given, as in that condition there is a formula to calculate the value of n, that is n is equal to 1.035 plus 0.1x. That is, as x is already given, that is 0.9, as you after placing the x value 0.9, you can calculate the value of n, that is 0.13035 plus 0.1 into 0.9, that is n is equal to 1.125. then p2 is then you substitute the value of n, that is p2 by p1 is equal to 2 by n plus 1 whole to the power of n by n minus 1. By submitting the value of n, you can get this p2 by p1 is equal to 0.579. then you can calculate the p2 is equal to 9 into 0.57, then it is a value pt is equal to 5.2 bar. Now you have the three pressures, that is the pressure at inlet, pressure at exit, and pressure at throat, p1, p2 and p3. So another important point is 10% lost in divergent section, that is you can take as a value of k, that is 0.9 at exit. As the calculated one, that is the cross section, find the ratio of cross sectional area, that is throat to the exit, that is a2 by a3. As you already note the mass discharge formula, that is a2 v2 by x2 vs2 is equal to a3 v3 by x3 vs3. This is the formula. You can rearrange this into, you can rearrange this as a2 v2 by x2 vs2 is equal to a3 v3 by x3. As another important point here, x3 is somewhat improved as the friction, some heat is released, and that heat is used to improve the dryness fraction of the outlet steam at the exit. That's why x3 is modified. In the previous problem, you directly taken x3 from 0.3, but here it is not possible to take the x3 directly. As x3 is somewhat modified, that is, then it is modified into x3, modified as a x3 dash. That's why I modify this formula, a2 v2 x by x2 vs2 is equal to a3 v3 by x3 dash and vs3. All are same, only at in this condition, that is the friction, that x3 condition is only condition, that is x3 dash is modified. So now you rearrange this formula, a2 by a3, as here the ratio of throat area to exit area, then it is a2 by a3. In the previous problem it is a3 by a2, but here the ratio is asking as a2 by a3, that is after rearranging this v3 x2 vs2 by v2 x3 dash vs3. So now here all these are the unknowns. V3 is the velocity at exit, x2 x3 dash vs2 vs3. As you have already known, v3 and v2, there is a formula 44.72 square root of h1 minus h3. At the same time, v3 is also modified, that is 44.72 square root of h1 minus h3 dash. So enthalpy is also reduced as there is a friction drop inside the divergent section. So in previous problem you take care of the h3, but here due to the enthalpy drop is lost, so it is modified into h3 dash. You should note that h3 dash and x3 dash. So as you already, the v3 and v2 are calculated from the formulas, x3 and x3 dash are noted from, identified from the Mollier diagram. Vs2 and Vs3 are from steam tables. So V3, V2 calculated one, V2 and X2 and X3 dash are from Mollier diagram, Vs2 and Vs3 from steam tables. So now we are going to draw a Mollier diagram. So this is the Mollier diagram. So this is the x is equal to one line. So as the steam in this problem is wet condition, that is P1 is equal to, so 9 bar, x1 is equal to 0.9 condition, that's why. So you first identify a x is equal to 0.9 line, and so P is equal to 9 bar line, then you tick this mark, and you identify another exit pressure is 2 bar line. This is 2 bar line, P is equal to 2 bar line. So you draw a straight line from directly from 1 to 3. This is 3. You can directly read these values, that is H1, this is H3. In previous problem I wrongly write this as a H2, please note that. So H1 and H3. So after that P2 is already calculated. P2 is equal to 5.2 bar. Then you identify another line, so that is P2 is equal to 5.2. So this is the 0.2. You can directly read this H2 as here. So after that you can calculate, you can another value, that is X2. X2 is also taken from here, but X3 is not advised to take, as there is a friction. Because of the friction, so this line is remodified like this. That's why you need to take the X3 dash value here. So how it is modified, after I will tell you after sometime. So here the actual Mollier diagram, here the actual Mollier diagram. This is the line, this is the 10 bar line, as the 9 bar line is identified here. So a 9 bar line, to you draw a straight line, straight directly to the P is equal to 1 bar line, straight line. So H3 is taken, H1 is taken, and identify 5.6 bar line, and you can take the line. So X2 is directly, you can read this is 0.85 line, 8687, X3 is equal to 0.87. and after that all the values H1, H2, H3 are read directly here H1, H2, H3, H1, H2, H3, all the values are taken. But H3 value must be calculated, as H3 dash value should be calculated, and H3 we cannot use H3. So that's why H3, the formula for H3 dash here, H2 minus K into H2 minus H3 dash. So you can simply, that is H3 is equal to H2, what is 2480 dash minus K is equal to 10% loss, that is friction factor is 0.9. So H2 2480 minus H3 2340. After calculation you obtain a new value, that is H3 dash 2354. This is the H3 dash. So all the values are ready. So here one important point, here enthalpy is calculated here, but H1, H2, H3 are measured from the Mollier diagram, but here H3 dash is calculated here only. So that's why you need to go back to the Mollier diagram just like this. So first of all you identify here the H3 dash, and draw a straight line to the exit bar line. Draw a straight line, this is here, this is the point, but you need not touch this point, but you touch the pressure line here, you touch this line, this is the point of 3 dash. You should, so as H3 is calculated from the formula, you identify here only, not here only. So from here you draw a straight line to the exit pressure line. You draw a straight line to the exit pressure line, and then put as a 3 dash. As you already know that from 1 to 3 you draw a straight line. So 1, this is the 2, this is the 3. But here as the 10% lost, this line just modified as this is, as pressure drop is lost, this is the lost in pressure drop. So that's why this point is little bit modified, and the dryness fraction is increased, that is here x3 dash can be measured, point something. So here x3 dash is measured 0.84. Here also you can see that. So there is a line. So there is a line h3 dash as h3 dash is calculated 2354. That is 2354 here. So you draw a line. You draw a line to one bar. You draw a line here. This is the point. As this is the one bar line. Here 3 is here, but 3 dash is here. So as this line continues one bar line, this is the 3, this is the 3 dash. So after taking all the values and you also take the values from steam tables also, that is VS2 and VS3. That is at P2 5.2 bar and P3 is 2 bar. That VS2 is equal to 0.361 and VS3 is equal to 0.8851. After submitting, that is A2 by A3, V3 is calculated, V2 is calculated, X2 and X3 dash from Mollier diagram, VS2 and VS3 from steam tables. Here the values are noted here. So by simply submitting the values here, only important point, only the modification is the x3 dash and h3 dash when fraction in a particular section, only these values are modified. So as h3 dash is calculated from formula h2 minus k into h2 minus h3, and by using this new h3 dash, you go and identify the new point 3 dash on the same pressure line and measure the x3 dash. This is the only one change from the previous problem.